Welcome to the L1 Engines YouTube channel. Today it's tuning. It's going to be the pre-tuning checklist is what I'm going to talk about. Things that you should do prior to going to get a street tune. In a second video later, I'm going to talk about pre-dyno tuning checklist. And that's a lot different than, oh, let's say for the street tune. So let's get right to the pre-tuning checklist for a street tune. All right, we're going to the checklist. I have it right here in my hand. It's available at my website for download, so you don't have to make one up. You need to tape it to your car window and mark off after everything's done. Number one, check for tight intake and tight exhaust. And that's, you're checking for vacuum leaks and you're checking for exhaust leaks. The exhaust leaks skew the O2 sensor readings. The intake leaks, they're vacuum leaks, and that messes with the manifold air pressure. It messes with mass flow detector. It's hard on the idle. So to check that's the smoke check or a shop air pressurized test. If you don't have the ability to do that, it's possible your tuner may offer that service. So that's very important. Check for tight intake and tight exhaust. Number two, fuel pump and fuel pressure. It needs to be sound. That needs to be verified. Also, no fuel leaks. Number three, ensure you have fresh O2 sensors. Number four, install new spark plugs. Make sure they're gapped right. Double check your spark plug wires for cracks and touching headers. Spark plugs and spark plug wires. Number five, have a list of all your modifications so that your tuner can reference that and make it detailed. And don't forget things like rear gear ratio, tire size, torque converter, wet stall, mass flow detector, if you have a different one. Most importantly, the fuel injector, the brand, and the part number on the fuel injector. That's real important detail. Number six is drive shaft and the U-joints. They need to be in good condition. It's a safety thing. Number seven, verify spark timing with a timing light. It sounds a bit extreme, right? Most of these late model cars, they didn't come with mechanical pointer like the old school cars. They don't even have timing marks on the dampers. But take the effort to at least put the mechanical pointer on the front of your motor, find top dead center. If you don't have a damper that has timing marks, you can get tape, put the old school timing tape on there. And it's important to do this. If you get to the shop, they have the ability to take the PCM and force it to command a steady spark advance, such as like 20 degrees spark at idle. Then he can take the timing light and verify spark. It is a good tool. It's good to know that your actual commanded timing with the computer is what you're seeing at the crankshaft. Number eight, verify battery voltage and a good alternator. That's real important. You don't want to waste time at the shop. Number nine, tires. They need to be in good condition, especially when you're going out on the street and it's the safety of the tuner and you. Number 10, fresh oil change. Fuel and dirt in the oil is not good. So no dirt or fuel in the oil. Okay, that final tip. For those of you who enjoy tuning, the process of tuning, think about getting or investing in a good scanner. Let me suggest HP tuners. You can get that for $300 now at Summit. You don't need to have tuning credits yet. You don't need to buy it with credits, the two GM credits, but you can get it for scanning. The benefit is going to be that you're going to get some seat time. You're going to get to sift through the data logs, see what your engine's doing, see if there's maybe some check engine lights. Maybe the O2 sensors are a bit lazy. You're going to learn a lot. If you're the type that likes to know what's going on, you can look over the shoulder of your tuner. I don't mind it. I enjoy if my customers know all about their car and they have a good knowledge of tuning, it makes my tuning much more fun. All right, I do know most of you have highly modified hot rods, and that's what makes this pre-tuning checklist all that much more relevant. So print a copy, tape it onto your windshield as you do each task, check off that task, then go to your tuning session and enjoy. This is Carl Elwine. Take care.